MashaAllah, the brother read a couplet there. I quickly want to talk about this point. And then inshallah we have a few Nathans and our guests will come. And I mentioned this last year because you mentioned the couplet. And I want to mention this again. That when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they migrated from Makkah to Medina. They stopped in the way at this lady's house whose name was Ummay Ma'bad. Her name was Ummay Ma'bad. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went there and they went to this lady and they said, "Oh lady, do you have any food or water or drink to provide? Do you have anything?" And this is what she would do. She would serve the people that were traveling. This lady said, "I don't have anything. My parents be ransomed for you. If I had anything, I would have given it to you." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had seen a goat in the corner that was there, that was weak. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to this lady, "That do you allow me to milk this goat?" She said, "It is weak and he has no milk in the udders." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked her, "If you allow, I will milk this goat." The goat was brought to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by Amir Mu'min Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the name of Allah, and by the name of Allah ta'ala, all of a sudden the udders were full with milk. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam milked this goat until all of the buckets and all of the bartan that Ummay Ma'bad had, all of them were full with milk. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave this milk to Ummay Ma'bad to drink. They gave it to the companions to drink. And then they drank the milk at the end. Once again, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam milked the goat again, and there was the same amount of milk again in the udders. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they filled all of the containers with milk. And they said to Ummay Ma'bad, "When your husband comes, give him this milk to drink." And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left. And then, when Abu Ma'bad came home, the husband of Ummay Ma'bad, he came home and he had seen all the containers full with milk. And he said to his wife, "The where did this milk come from?" And out of astonishment, she was still in awe and still in shock. She had seen such a handsome man. She said, "Mubarak came." She said, "Today in our house, who came?" "Mubarak came, the blessed man." And Abu Ma'bad said, "Describe him to me. Who's Mubarak? How was he? Describe him to me." Now listen, this is the description. Only few words I'm going to say. People say a messenger looks like this. No, a messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the highest of creation. You cannot describe his beauty. Is high. Allah Ta'ala created him with the highest of beauty. Ummay Ma'bad described a few words. She says, "Ra'aytu rajulan zahirat al-wada." That I have seen a man with cleanliness, with striking appearance. This is the first description she says. She says, "I have seen ablajul waj, radiant face, husn al-khulq, beautiful, beautifully created, wasimun kasimun, handsome and proportionate, fi aynihi da'jun, in his eyes the blackness was black and the whiteness was white." She describes a messenger like this, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. She said, "Wa fi sawtihi sahlun," that in his voice was an echo, was raspiness. She says, "The ajmaluhu min ba'idin," when you looked at him from far away, he was beautiful. "And wa ajmaluhu min qareebin," and when you looked at him from closer, he was more handsome. 18 descriptions Ummay Ma'bad mentioned about this man called Mubarak. She named him Mubarak. Her husband says, "Ummay Ma'bad, I know this man. This man is from Quraysh. Then when I see him, I will follow him." Then one day, Ummay Ma'bad, along with the son, they're outside in Madinah Sheikh shopping. And always when Abu Ma'bad would come home, he would say to Ummay Ma'bad, "Describe Mubarak to me. Tell me, how did Mubarak look?" And Ummay Ma'bad would describe Mubarak in these words. And one day she's shopping away in Madinah Sharif with a child. And the child says, "Ya Ummah, Ummah Mudda, Ar-Rajul Alladhi Ma'al Mubarak." That man, he was with Mubarak. She sees Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq. They rush towards Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq. And they say to Amir al-Mu'mineen, "Where is Mubarak?" Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq looks and says, "Who is Mubarak?" He said, "Remember when you were migrating from, and you stopped at my house, and you filled your container with the milk, you had the milk there to drink, and Mubarak was with you." Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq says, "I know who is Mubarak. I will take you to Mubarak." Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq takes Ummay Muhammad to Mubarak to Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam and says, let me recite La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. She enters in the fold of Islam. This is a description of Messenger sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. The most handsome, when the companions looked and said, Aksana minka lam tarakattu aini, wajmalu minka lam talidin nisa'u, khulikta mubarra ammin kuli aibin, ka annaka qad khulikta kama tasha'u. This is our Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Learn the description and you will know how your messenger looked. Be with the messenger sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam in this dunya. Most of the time we want to be with the messenger hereafter. No, be with the messenger in this dunya. Follow him, practice sunnah, keep the beard. Even in the description, the Ummay Muhammad mentioned that he had a thick beard. The Messenger sallallahu ta'ala had a beautiful beard. Practice his sunnah, be with him in the world, and you will be with him in hereafter, inshallah. Ya Habib.